Sometimes we get stuck when we get a lot of feedback and we don't know how to address it, right? The smartest person in this room is not me. Who is it? The room. So we're gonna be doing some problem speed dating.
When we do problem speed dating in my class, students are learning the power of collaboration and action. We feel like we're stuck, but the reality is we can quickly find solutions to our problems when we use each other and the strength that every person has.
Like thinking about your sentences before you write them down, brainstorm about them. Those would be my biggest suggestions.
So often in school, we concentrate on deficits. Kids see, oh, I'm not good at math. They look at what they're not good at. I want kids to realize they have their own personal strength, and that's the purpose of school. It's to help you find what you are good at.
Hey guys, good morning. Make sure you go in and grab your journal. Now, I want you to look for a problem or a stuck point you're having. It can be from a previous essay. It can be from your journal. Find something you're struggling with.
So the activity we did in class today was problem speed dating. The students are currently concentrating on expressing themselves through the argumentative essay. So they went through their journal where they have multiple pieces of feedback and they looked for trends to figure out a problem that's coming up over and over again. And from there, they wrote down that problem on a sheet of paper.
I wrote down that I had a problem with my word selection. Like I feel like I repeat words too much.
So here's what we're gonna do. You're gonna take your problems and I need you to stand across from a partner. You're gonna line up.
We paired up and then we'd get 30 seconds to tell the other person what our problem was and then they'd give us advice they'd have to fix that.
My problem is grammar and word choice.
What I find helps me is that I read it out loud like as if I'm talking to someone. It really helps to find fragmented sentences, run-ons.
They give you solutions, you write them down, and then you switch, they tell you their problem, and you give them solutions. Then after that, you move down the line and you get a new partner.
Ready, set, move.
And you just do the same thing.
I feel like I don't always have three good reasons to support my point. It's better to have feedback from different people versus just one, because every person's different.
I make sure that the students end up with at least 3 to 4 solutions in order to have this activity be completely effective.
I get a lot of solutions. Use a thesaurus, use synonyms, and also ask people around you to read your writing because they can tell better than you that you're repeating words too much.
If you have one dart and you throw it at a dartboard, are you gonna hit it? You're probably not. But if you take dart after dart and you keep throwing them because you have more darts, are you more likely to hit the target? Yes. How many of you now have solutions to your problem? Raise your hand. This is how powerful it is when we utilize each other. You're gonna go back to your seat. I want you to come up with a plan of action.
So the plans of actions are going to be put into effect when they have their next essay next week. I actually have an entire booklet for each student of every plan of action they have. It's like a portfolio of their learning, and it's a great way for them to review before they start writing.
It was very helpful to have the plan of action when I did my essay last week. Helps my essays make sense more. I think that the self-awareness you get from this exercise is very beneficial. You can listen to other people's problems so you don't make the same mistakes.
I want to show the students that their expertise is needed in the conversation of learning. Ultimately, they become the teachers in the room, which also gives them confidence to use their strengths out in the world.